When I switched from Premiere Pro to Final Cut Pro, the number one thing that bothered me was seeing this message. You see, Final Cut Pro, when it comes to file management, is like that friend who wants to help, but somehow always finds a way to mess things up or to make things worse. By default, Final Cut Pro automatically creates copies of your files, your footage, your clips. So here is what we're gonna do. Let's tell Final Cut Pro to stop creating those files that we don't need in the first place. Because the problem is every time Final Cut Pro creates these files, these copies, it actually takes more space on your hard drive. First, go to Final Cut Pro, Preferences, and then Import. When you get here, go ahead and uncheck Copy to Library Storage Location and leave files in place. We don't want any copies. We want to save space. But for this to work, guys, you cannot leave your footage, your clip in your SD card. And I hope you've never done that anyway, because that's not really good practice. We never know what can happen with an SD card. Actually, I had to learn about that the hard way. This was my tough Sony SD card. So before you import your clips into Final Cut Pro, transfer them into a hard drive. And maybe even copy them into another hard drive for backups. I highly recommend that you always have backups. The second tip will be to tell Final Cut Pro to stop transcoding your clips when you import them. So it's still gonna be in Preferences, Import, and uncheck both Create Optimized Media and Create Proxy Media. Both are supposed to be more manageable copies of your original footage, but again, those copies are not necessary unless you're working maybe with a very heavy codec, but that's probably very rare and probably just happened in a very high-end project. The next step is to stop all background rendering. Go to Preferences, go to Playback, and uncheck Background Render. Why is that important? Every time you do something on the timeline, Final Cut Pro will start creating this temporary file so that you can have a high quality playback. These dotted lines on top of your timeline will tell you which part of your timeline is not rendered. So when you add an effect, when you add a transition, when you cut, when you trim, all of that, Final Cut Pro will render or will create a copy of your clip in the background, a temporary copy of your clip in the background, and that will take a lot of space. But when I edit, every now and then I need to render certain portion of the timeline, and the way to do that is simple. You just need to select that portion, that range, or that clip. With that portion selected, with that range selected, with that clip selected, go to Modify and then click on Render Selection. Or you can also press Control R. And of course, it will still create those temporary files that we talked about earlier, but at least it's not gonna take that much space because you only render what you need to render. An extra thing that you can do is when you're done editing or maybe even exporting your final product, you can actually tell Final Cut Pro to delete all generated copies, all generated files, and that will definitely free up your space. And the way to do that is simple. You select the event or select the library, the entire library if you want to, and go to File and go down to Delete Generated Files. And then you can choose to delete all or only the unused generated render files, and that's it. If you guys want more Final Cut Pro tips, go check out these videos, and I will see you guys in the next one.